gets counted again. Another Yuko on the board there. The last 4 seconds going, and Crockett played an absolutely perfect match, enough to win the bronze medal.
Sports didn't start off for me as like wanting to like be an athlete. It started off as something I needed for survival. My reasons for competing and my reasons for training as hard as I did was as if my life depended on it. In middle school, I was attacked and robbed. After that incident, like one of the things I told myself was that I was never going to be that helpless and scared again, because like I saw my own death that night. Like I saw myself being murdered that night. And like I had no control, had no way to defend myself, had no way of even like coping with it after the fact. Sports not only became a way for me to cope with that, and also a way for me to find some healing with that, but also it began like it began my tool for survival. As I was going through my athletic career and like building all this muscle and like getting as strong as I possibly could, I was building armor around a lot of the trauma that had happened to me through my childhood. And in building this armor around, I had kind of created a barrier. After I retired and slowed down, that's when everything just kind of like came to the surface all at once. And like no amount of working out, no amount of like getting into the gym or like doing judo practice was gonna help me clear any of that or like move through any of it. Teach a social emotional learning curriculum that's also steeped in understanding identity, self-awareness, trauma, and just other aspects of life that aren't necessarily talked about in schools or really in social circles. So it's really cool to be able to bring this language to students who are battling with a lot of the similar things I battled with growing up. It's tools for them to use in their academic life, but more importantly in their home life as well. It became my passion immediately, because I loved what I was doing and I recognized immediately that it helped me move through my own trauma. Children understand pain and they understand when they're suffering. They just don't have the language for it. Some of the journaling exercises I do help them create the language for it, because it's not me writing out their thoughts, it's them. And then it's them seeing it and then connecting the dots that like, all right, this is out and I haven't been thinking this for a while. I'm happy that I haven't been thinking this stuff for a while. How do I keep this stuff out of my mind? And then, so from there, it's just like creating that practice, because everything I teach with my students, I do it every day for myself. I feel completely different than I ever had after losing that weight, and also losing a lot of the trauma that was sort of caked in with it. It allowed me to start creating a more of a workout routine that was centered around healing. Trauma, it's like a wound that keeps happening to you over and over and over again until you begin to deal with it. But the only way to deal with it is to open that wound back up and to go back through and start cleaning out everything that's in it. Know that your peace is power. After high school, like the D'Artagnan I knew in Cleveland had to completely change, and I began to be D'Artagnan, the athlete training for Paralympics. Then giving my entire self to that, like after retiring almost abruptly, didn't know who to retire to. I didn't know who D'Artagnan was. To every athlete, to every person who's struggling with mental health, trauma, with whatever it is you're going through, especially if you're struggling with a sense of self, give yourself patience, time, and grace, and know that there's a solution. Know that there is something on the other side.